Baruch, good morning, Rabotai. Shavuot Tov. There are three kedushot that we say during Shacharit. First is during Yotzer Or. Second is during Chazarat Hashat, Kedusha, Kadosh Kadosh. And then the third time is Kedushat Sidra during Uvah Letzion Goel. The very interesting machloket that Bet Yosef and Siman Nun Tet brings down is what we say in Yotzer Or, before Kriyat Shema. Is that considered, when we say Kadosh Kadosh and Baruch Kevod Hashem Mekomo, is that considered a real Kedusha? What's the difference? The question is, can you say it with Erev Minyan? So, he brings down very interestingly, one of the several times that the Bet Yosef quotes the Zohar Kadosh, that the Kedusha in Yotzer, the Kadosh in Baruch in Yotzer, is considered a full Kedusha, which means that according to that, you would not be able to say it with Erev Minyan. You hear that? Zohar Kadosh Meforash. So if that's the case, what do you do if a person's praying B'Yechidut? Says the Bet Yosef, that you would have to read it B'Te'amim. It's from the Navi. Kadosh, 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 Hashem Tzvaot. And Baruch Kivod Hashem Mekomo are psukim from the Navi Yeshaya. So he says if you're praying with Erev Minyan, according to the Zohar, you would have to say these psukim b'te'amim, like the te'amim in the Navi. If you don't know them, don't say it. Learn it. And then say it. Now, so he says, but what do? We don't find that the Gemara talks about it. We don't find that Masechet Sofrim talks about it. What do you do? Says the Bet Yosef Maskanat HaAlacha, since we don't find that the Shas, that the Gemara disagrees with the Zohar, he says the Halacha does follow the Zohar. And therefore it is considered a Kiddusha. However, he points out himself, the Bet Yosef, that the Minhag HaOlam happens to be that even without a Minyan, people say this Kiddusha. And therefore, Be'emet, Meikar HaAlacha, if a person can, if a person's praying without a Minyan, a person should say these Psukim with the Te'amim. B'diavad, if a person doesn't know, the Te'amim, whatever it is, the person can rely on the Minhag HaOlam that the Bet Yosef brings down, that people would say Kadosh Uvaruch, even without Te'amim, even without Minyan. Interestingly enough, the Mishnah Berura quotes, in Siman Yutet, he quotes a Pri Chadash, who says that what happens, that's if a person's praying without a Minyan. What happens if a person's in a Minyan, but he's late, he's behind the Tzibur. The Tzibur already said it. Over there, the Pri Chadash brings down that over there you can say it even without Te'amim because you're in the presence of 10 people. So over there, everybody would agree that you don't have to say it with Te'amim because you are in a Minyan even though you are late.